Time to bring the bass bird. Sir, I'm going big like a lineman. She want bring the limes in. She wanna pull up to the crib, we can't dine in. Up right away, couldn't even get a vine in. Straight with the money, we aligned in. Tell me how they broke, tryna chime in. Jesus watching over here in diamonds.
And thank you, Coach. We are across the Hudson from Midtown Manhattan at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Dallas Cowboys and the New York Giants. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line.
Check out! Right in it! Watch the screen! Watch the screen! Watch the screen!
11-Z!
Hey, check! Red zone!
Now a first down throw, Locke. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. First down for the Giants as they pick up 12.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is that the one-dimensional receiver is really starting to leave the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you've got to run fast. Of course, you've got to catch the ball. But route running savvy and toughness, there's a premium for all of that now.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. From the gun, here's Locke. He rifles one that's intercepted. He's picked off near his own 48. He's coming off a three-interception performance last week, so certainly not how we wanted to start here.
Not at all, but this is where a quarterback gets tested. This is where we find out what he has underneath that jersey, because he had a bad game last week. Can he shake off a bad start to this one to start to perform at the level he expects?
And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the one. Second and goal from the one. He'll try to run this one in, and he'll get in. Touchdown, Cowboys. A great play there. His second touchdown on the season, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Extra point from McManus is good, and it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score as they start first and 10. And now the drive starts with a completion out to the right. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one.
He's coming. Strong right.
Shift. 25. Check 25.
On the ground, this is Saquon Barkley. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
That's how you pick up a first down. You know where the sticks are, you know where the first down marker is, and you find a way to get there. That's called having vision.
He had a lot of vision last week, didn't he? NFC Offensive Player of the Week, he was dominant. This one across midfield into Cowboy territory. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Brings up second and seven at the 48-yard line.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Now Saquon Barkley. And he's got this pretty close to a first down at the Cowboys 42.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
This is third and one, very likely four down territory, even if they don't get it, though. They'll try to run for it with Barkley. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. It's a pickup of six and good enough to move the chains. He was well over 100 yards last week. He told us this week, a little ambitious, said he wants to hit that 200 mark. We'll see.
Makes sense, though, doesn't it? Have we ever run into a running back that had a great game the week before that didn't think that's just going to naturally continue? Just make sure you feed me the football. And that's what they're all about. Continuity, rhythm, number of carries. Just keep giving it to him. What's the old expression, 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. They'll run with Barkley. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size and these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Here's the seventh play of this drive. This is third and four.
Switch, switch, switch. Pick the edge, pick the edge. 11, 11, 11.
A give to Barkley out of the gun. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
Six guys. Charge 40. Easy, easy. Alert, alert.
First and 10 at the 23-yard line.
Luck on first down. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe you want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive. On second down, Prather. Only a yard on the pickup there, so it leaves him needing a conversion here on third and a tough nine. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
And on third down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back.
Check three.
A shotgun snap for Love. Eluding the pressure right. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Oh, and after the sack, he's still down on the field. We'll get an update when we return to MetLife Stadium. And Rosas puts this one through. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. A dozen plays on that drive that ends with the field goal.
Let's go ahead and break out some of the old chestnuts here, right, partner? Keep the ball in front, rally to it, and make the tackle, right? No big plays given up, no balls over your head. Ben, don't break.
Hold on. Chestnuts?
You like
Come
that
on.
One?
What does that mean, break out? Just because you break chestnuts?
I'm not sure about that, but I'm just going with why they said that. I have no idea.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Second and six at the 27-yard line.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Second and six. Blitz coming, and down he goes.
Man, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
Third and long. Beer. And he's going to go down again. Bradley Chubb doing what he does best, getting that sack.
Brandon, what I remember most about playing with guys who knew how to rush the passer, they would just tell you, just cover people for me, just long enough for me to get there. And that's exactly what happened on that play.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
Six yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Saquon Barkley running right. And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. The Giants on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and eight. And here comes throw number one for the backup QB. Looking downfield for Jones. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
But one thing's for sure, when you get a big receiver and you trust him downfield, you're going to give him opportunities to go up and get that 50-50 ball.
And he is a darn good big receiver. Unfortunately, that time didn't work out. Nice job defensively. And that ball's going to angle out at the 3-yard line. A beauty.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. A little bit of space there for the first down run, as that's going to get him about 5 yards. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. On second down now,
Shields.
And he will take this up to about the 8-yard line. They follow up the gain of 5 by only getting 1 there on second down. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down. He gets this away. It's a good one, drawing toward the sidelines. And the punt goes out of bounds. Where will they put it? They'll put it just inside the 45-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. It's been very much a slow start for them. 3 drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is 1. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
19 yards there on the catch and run. And this is a guy who last week not only helped his real team, but really helped a lot of fantasy teams. 3 trips to pay dirt, they've got a container.
And watching him play is like going to lunch with you when you order that combo plate, right? In this case, his combo plate is he can go over the top of you and catch it in front, turn it into a big game, run past you, and then uses his size and his physical abilities to keep you away from the football.
And he's got it! Touchdown, Giants! Julio Jones! His first touchdown on the year. And the Giants have taken the lead.
Boy, that route is really tough to cover because if they're running it correctly, you think it's really going to be a slant.
Yeah, well, we talk all the time about how it's tough to execute offensively, but you're saying, don't forget, it's tough to cover for the defense, too.
Yeah, the number one thing that you're taught is to not get caught inside or get beat inside. So you guard that a little bit more. So that gives you a little bit more space to operate outside if you start your move initially inside if you're a receiver.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. Going to give this time to the tailback. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47.
So if you've been playing defense in this one, there's a little bit of the good and some bad because they did give up the touchdown run to him earlier but shut him down otherwise.
Outside of that, you're exactly right. I would say they've contained him very well. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Second and 3. He's going to loft one deep left side here. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
I know the initial focus was on how far that pass was downfield, but how about the coverage on the play? Able to stay with him, get his hands where the receiver's hands were going to try and catch the ball, tips it up in the air, and knocks it away.
From the gun on 3rd down, Beer. This is Johnson, he's got it. And he's got the 1st down yardage as he takes it down to the 49. It'll be a pickup of 4, good enough to earn him yet another 1st down. So the drive takes him into Giants territory now, 1st and 10 at the 49-yard line. They'll try the left side. Shields. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 17 yards on the play there, and the Cowboys have a 1st down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And able to break 1 tackle, but then quickly brought down. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six.
Let's get off the field, Pete. Let's get off the field.
And an alley to run. Give them 15 there. The Cowboys have a first.
Well, partner, for a few years there, we thought this read option play was going to take over the whole NFL. It seemed like everyone was using it. But it has been scaled back considerably in the last few seasons, mainly because people worried about their quarterbacks getting hit. But when you call it at the right time and you use it properly, you see the type of gains you can get. A nice chunk of yardage there by the quarterback.
2 minutes remaining in the first half. 10-7, our score. We'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. To throw on second down. Beard looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. It's been a pretty long drive. This will be play number 9, and they need 10 yards out of it on third. Operating from the gun, Beard. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. A 14-yard touchdown, and the Cowboys have retaken the lead. Precision, precision, precision. That's the definition of it right there. Great pass, great catch for the score.
Yeah, people talk about arm strength all the time. Well, if you're not precise and you're not accurate, the arm strength really doesn't matter. We saw a little bit of everything with that throw.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive tumble.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
So the face mask, quite a blessing there as they'll start out of harm's way with a first and 10. After the penalty, they go with Barkley. And just 1 yard here from the 49 to the 50.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9.
Sustained is a loss. We're taking wins home.
From the 50, it's long. Looking deep for Julio. And this is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a third down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9.
Monday, Mike 13. Hey, hey, hey.
Crawl, crawl, crawl.
Out of the gun, Luck. It's caught, Jones. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. It's a gain of 11 and a Giant first down. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to get this inside the 30. First down for the Giants as they pick up 12.
First and 10 at the 26-yard line.
12, 13. He's coming. Check in.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
From the 22, Luck. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down.
6 yards to go.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6.
Kill. 11.
Throwing is locked. And that is incomplete. 2 seconds left on the clock. So with 2 ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. He connected on his first. This time it's 39 yards away. And the kick by Rosas is good. And the lead is down to 1 now at 14-13. So a very tight first half. We had to break in a 1-point game. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They have the lead now. They'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ballgame.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up, because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Here's 2nd and 8. And an alley to run. He finds an opening past the 40. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the 3rd one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
First and 10, Beard. Johnson's got it complete. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. 14 yards, good for a Cowboy first down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
So the drive takes him into Giants territory now, first and 10 at the 45-yard line. And able to push forward for right around 3 yards down to the 42.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
Looking to throw on second down. Beard, he's going to float this one deep right side. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
And they'll need to get to the 35 if they want to keep this drive going on third down. From the gun, Beard. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. And this one is right down the middle. And that'll move their lead up to four now. Well, looking at it from a defensive perspective, that keeps a deficit very, very manageable. You know, all things considered, not a bad job on the defensive side.
I would say that you pointed out something pretty good right there, and that is you actually have both sides happy with that exchange. You know, happy in quotes, of course. One team, hey, we've kept it within range. The other side saying, hey, we put points on the board and did stretch out the lead. Let's see how this one turns out.
Yeah, still bottom line, though, 3 points for the opening drive of the third quarter. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Here's second and seven now from the 28. Now it's locked. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third. But the passing game right now for them, not overly impressive. Last week he hit on right at 50%. This week he's under 50%.
And it's not just on him. Protection, a few breakdowns along the way that's made him get off the spot. Receivers not getting their way open downfield. The coverage has been awfully tight. They've got to all get together and find ways to make this passing game get in gear.
Complete to Jones. Give him 8 yards on the play, and they pick up the first.
Nice catch right there. Brings to mind the sentence, when in doubt, find your veterans.
I used to laugh back in the day when they would call guys like him crafty veterans. You get up in your 30s, you're still playing receiver, but you're around that long at that position, you're doing something right.
Just remember this. When he was young, he thought the crafty veteran was simply a guy who couldn't run anymore. Now he understands a little bit better.
They run with Barkley on first down, and he gets about 5 out of it. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Brings up second and 5 at the 41-yard line.
After the pickup of 5, here's second and 5.
Mike 19. You. 12.
Here's Lund. And he fires one that's intercepted. He's picked off near his own 48. And they take over. They'll set up shop at the 46-yard line.
Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
They'll run on first down. Wakefield. A gain of 3, second down.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
They'll keep it on the ground. Wakefield. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. It's a gain of 12, and the Cowboys pick up the first.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Off play action. Beard. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. In for the score. And the Cowboys turn that interception into a touchdown. And that is the definition of yards after catch. They go short on the pass, and the receiver does the rest.
Seems so harmless, doesn't it? To throw it underneath, a short pass like that. But boy, it gets dangerous in the hands of the right receiver as he makes a move and takes it the distance.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. That second down play nets a minus 4. Third and long. It's locked. Looks to throw, fires right side, and that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down. On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about 4 more for a first. Season both in this game. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further. So on third and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
One play has them up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Out of the shotgun, they run with Barkley. And able to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47. Second and five now. Luck. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Brings up third and five.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends.
You better bring
on third down, Barkley. Three quarters in the books. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. They're already slim hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down. Here we go on fourth. Luck. Under pressure and down he goes. Luck is sacked. The Giants go on fourth but come up empty. And Dallas, they'll take over in terrific field position. On first down, Shields. They'll fight forward for a couple down inside the 40. Good job there keeping him to a short gain. Of course, he's coming off a really terrific performance, reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week.
And I know people get caught up in, well, if you're the reigning Defensive Player of the Week, you must have made a bunch of spectacular plays. Like, you mixed in a few of those, but most of the plays are just like we saw there. Keep him to short gains, make the fundamental tackle. Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
The Cowboys on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and four. The gun, Beard. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by the Michigan man, Jabril Peppers. The 30, the 20, and he will score. Touchdown, Giants. Rosas now to end the PAT. And that one makes this an 11-point deficit now. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Now, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. They'll run it now out of the gun. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
A good pickup there, 21 yards.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
Oh, so frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
Pretty solid run here on first down. Almost picked up another first, but he appears to be a few inches short. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
At the 45-yard line.
An ideal spot here to get a first down and try to run some more clock, and this is second and less than a yard. They'll keep it on the ground. Shields, and he'll get it down here to the 43. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Well, I don't think there's any question, Brandon, at this stage. The stop troops, the defensive guys, they've got to use their 3 timeouts here. They've got to stop them and get the ball back.
Yeah, if you're in that 2-3 score deficit window that they're in now, you got to get it ASAP.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Stop them, use your timeouts. Easier to move the ball on offense without timeouts than to stop them on defense without using them.
The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. So after the run for no gain, here's 2nd and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. The second down play, not much better than the first. Just a gain of 1 there. The Cowboys on 3rd down. They're at 50%, 4 for 8. This is 3rd and 9. Off the play fake. Beard. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Now the Giants will use the 2nd of their 3 timeouts. That's going to leave them with just 1 remaining here in this fourth quarter. Here's Sam Martin now as he's on to punt for Dallas. Averaging over 50 yards of punt so far as this one's away. And that'll kick and go out of bounds just outside the 15 at the 16-yard line.
At their own 16-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on 4th, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the #1 headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
up. But he trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. Another throw on 2nd down, and this one incomplete as well.
Brandon, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. The Giants on 3rd down, not quite 50%, 4 for 9. This is 3rd and 10. Luck now to throw. Looking downfield for Jones. And unable. able to connect. Incomplete. Now give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. They snap it to Love. And no, it's incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And boy, possession here turns over with a football already being in the red zone. They'll run on first down. Shields. And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. And now here comes the third of their timeouts defensively. So they'll be left with only the two-minute warning to stop it from here on out. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. They'll keep it on the ground. Shields. And effective running here. He'll take it down inside the 10. They get 9 yards back on the run there, and they're left with a much more makeable third and two. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. A great effort there. His second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further. McManus's point after is good. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at the 40. Back to throw, Love. Going to throw right side here, complete. First down, Giants on a pickup of 14. On first and 10, Locke. He'll get this out to Barkley, complete. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. First down, Giants on a pickup of 14. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. To throw is Locke. Taken in by the tight end, Doyle. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. On first down, it's Locke. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. Just nothing there again. He's been sacked multiple times. We've seen the interceptions, of course. He's really been through the ringer, hasn't he?
And what we've seen is a defense is well coordinated. The front and the back really in sync. The front putting on the pressure, the backside being ball hawks and picking passes off.
And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. Locke showing he can be dangerous when he tucks and runs. He's able to pick up the first down. Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the 2. No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal. Hey, you got 3 down. They got to have 6 here. It's third and goal.
Check nickel. Quo. Oh, yeah, I'm coming. Oh. 11. Mike 50. Night, night, sweetheart.
61, matchbox lights.
One last throw here for Locke. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
Fourth and goal at the 2-yard line.
And a field goal obviously means nothing here. They're going to go ahead and go for it on fourth down.
11, 11, 11. Kill, kill, kill. And turn it up, turn it up. Mike 19, Mike 19.
Got to do better. Come on, QB, come on.
Hey, quick, 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 quick.
19, Mike. One final shot. They'll look to throw. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Read it well, and it's picked. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. He's at the 50, 30, 20, 10. And he will score. Touchdown, Cowboys. And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And he'll be out of bounds well short of the goal line, so the attempt at the fake extra point unsuccessful. Well, we saw action to the final whistle in this one. Not only the touchdown at the end to add to their lead, then they tried to put more on top of the two-point conversion but didn't get it.
That's someone that wants to win and by as many as possible. They don't get the two-point conversion to add on top, but just the idea of going for it with that type of a lead already when they didn't need to do so, that tells you what his mentality is. He's an attack, attack, attack coach. Always attack.
So for Dallas, that early momentum continues here as they move to 4-0, and they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for the Giants, they'll fall back to 500 at 2-2, and they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. That'll do it for us.